What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy, Steph the Lawn Surgeon. And, got a new mower. So, you already know what time it is. A tip's a talk. Yep, and there she goes. Get that, get it in the screen. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna give y'all my I'm not gonna do a review yet. I'm gonna like to cut with it. I only cut my yard with it because my yard has a lot of different terrains, hills, ditches, and stuff. A little good test, and it opened my eyes about a couple things. But I'm gonna show y'all how I modified it so far, because y'all know me, y'all know I like to tweak it to me. But and then I'm also gonna give y'all my first impressions. All right, so here we go. This is a Toro floating deck T-bar walk behind. Yes, it is belt drive. These are the belts. So I guess that's the first thing I'll talk about. Put my old drink and drink down. For those who are wondering how the T-bars work, of course, pulley systems work by, you know, the tension and the tightening of belts. Here is the transmission here. What happens is, this is always constantly spinning when it's on, and I'll show y'all that when it's on. It's always constantly spinning. And so when you push forward on these, it pushes forward on that pulley, which tightens up on the belt, and the more it tightens up on the belt, the more it makes this wheel on this side move. You get what I'm saying? So that's pretty much how the T-bar works. This right here, that's your safety thing. But like I said, and that's your reverse, but I'll get more into that. The only modification I really made, number one, I took the flap off because I got a mulching kit on mine, put on mine. Mulching kit has different baffles under it. It actually divides the deck into Each blade is divided into their own containment area, because the way these decks are designed, they shoot grass over to the right side. So if you were just to put a plate on the side like that plate, then all the grass will still be shooting over to the wall, and it will eventually start dripping out the side. So basically, you have to, they have a special recycling kit that it contains each blade, and it also helps make a better suction, so it'll suck the grass and make it stand up, so you'll get a better cut. So that's that. The other modification I made so far, oh yeah, I adjusted these, the T-bars. It was a little loose, you know, I gotta get used to it. But the guy told me, he said, you know, when you first get it, you know, the belts might be a little loose, and you can adjust it to how you want it. So I did adjust it, made it a little better. I might adjust it a little more, but that's that. But the most important part is the striping. Y'all know me about the striping. I was thinking about getting a striping roller. I'm not even sure where they would put it, if they would put it on the back of the deck there or what. But first thing I noticed when I got it, it has a flap. And you know what I do with flaps. Bam, rebar already. So I put some, if y'all see up top there, I put some reinforcement zip ties up there, because of course the flap is not meant to hold this extra weight of the rebar. So So I put extra ones up there. And then, instead of what I did the first time with my Time Master, I just made one hole on the top, and then I ran the zip tie under the bottom and wrapped it like that. But what was happening was the zip ties will rub on the ground and they would end up getting worn out, like when I would go across the street or sidewalks and stuff. So I have to keep replacing them every once in a while. So this time I just put two holes to keep the zip ties up, and then that way it can you know, it still gets that weight on it. That's all you want. And it made it a little bad. If y'all can see in my yard right here, after I put the zip ties on, I did a couple of stripes right here. So made a little bit of difference. I'm gonna see how that is. I don't really want to put another piece of rebar on there, because like I said, that flap is not meant for that. And I had two on my Time Master flap, but now I only got one on there. So I'm gonna see how this does. When the lawn care rookie, he has a crazy dog. What was I saying? Oh yeah, lawn care rookie, he has a 48 inch. It's basically the same thing, 48 inch, and his stripes like crazy. But I think it's because it's heavier. Because his 48 inch, it's a different shaped deck as well. It's still the Turbo Force, but it's like this wide diamond shaped deck. So I guess that maybe that has something to do with why. But mine's been striped as well when I first cut it without putting a rebar on there. But reason I wanted to put that rebar on there, I'm gonna go sit in the shed in here. The reason I wanted to put that rebar on there, the actual day that I got it was kind of crazy. I was getting off work, and my plan that day was I was gonna go home. I had to go home. I had to cut somebody's front yard, because on Sunday I cut his backyard, and I was planning to cut his whole yard, but he was like he didn't want me to cut the front yard because he had just put some fertilizer down or something. So I said, okay, I'll come back during the week. So I was gonna come back that day, but I had to go home, cut his front yard, go back home, get my car so I could go pick up my daughter, right? So then the day just went awesome, you know what I mean? Most of the time I don't really get into personal stuff, but I'll let y'all in on this because the day went kind of awesome. So anyways, you know, I'm thinking I'm gonna have to rush around like that. So now I call my mom. So first of all, my mom tells me, oh, you know, she could pick up my daughter from daycare. So I'm like, oh, that's awesome. So now I don't have to, like, you know, rush around for that. I could just go cut the guy's yard. So as soon as I get off the phone with my mom, the dealer calls me. And they're like, hey, your lawnmower's ready and the striping and the mulching kit's on there. And I'm like, oh my gosh. So, but I gotta get to the dealer. Right at this point it's like 4, and I gotta get to the dealer by 5:30 because they closed. So I go home and get my van and my trailer. Then I start heading over to the dealer. So I get to the dealer, right? And so basically I had put a down payment on the lawnmower, but I still had to pay for the striping kit. So, you know, I had the money, but I was kind of saving it up because we're planning on going on a trip, you know, out of, you know, a vacation. So I wanted to save a little extra money for that. So I said, you know, oh, well, I guess I gotta, cause I plan on cutting that weekend. So I said, I guess I gotta, you know, just pay this money for the mulching kit and hope that I get paid for some money, you know, some jobs over the weekend. So that's what I did. And then, when I got there to pay for the mulching kit, she said, Elliot, well, you put down $1,500. Did you want to just add the mulching kit to your financing? And I was like, huh, I didn't even think about that. That is true, you know? So I said, yeah, sure. So I didn't have to pay the $250 that day. And then another good thing that happened that day was the fact that they were closing early the next day, Friday. because of 4th of July. And it was closing at 12, and I got off work the next day at 12. So if I had waited till the next day to come, I wouldn't have been able to get it. So I wouldn't have had it for the weekend to cut with it. So I'm like, man, you know, this day's going pretty good. Went from zero to hero pretty quick. So, you know, I didn't have to pay the money. Went around back. The guy was giving me, you know, showing me, you know, what's going on with it. So I got it loaded up. Headed back over here to the neighborhood because the yard that I needed to cut was like right around the whole corner from my house. Pulled up, you know, I was rolling past the house and I noticed the guy had cut his front yard already, you know. So, you know, I was feeling so good that day. I'm like, man, you know what? Because I would have charged him, I charged him $50 to cut his yard. And I was going to charge him like $25-$30 to cut his back, for cutting his back. His backyard is huge. So I said, you know what, man? I'm hype about this mower. I ain't even going to sweat that $30 because he's a real good customer. He's real good. He pays on time or whatever. So I said, I'm not even going to sweat that $30. So no sooner as I said that, a guy in that same neighborhood that I aerated like last year, he was rolling past me. He was like, hey, what's going on? I said, hey. He said, I've been watching you. You've been cutting that, you know, that guy's yard right there. And I want to see how you do cut my yard, you know. So I said, all right, yeah. He said, so when can you cut it? I said, I can cut it Saturday. He says, all right, so I'm going to pay you. I'm going to give you the money right now because I probably won't be home. So he sat there, pulled out his wallet, gave me $50 right there. And, you know, I'm going to go cut his yard off Saturday. So now they got me nervous because, like I said, this is my nice neighborhood that he's in. So now I'm about to have four of these houses in this nice neighborhood. And that's why I use my Time Master. Ooh, excuse me. To cut these front yards, because I can make nice straight crisp stripes. And now I'm about to give y'all my first impressions on this bad boy, because I'm all over the place with this thing. And don't get me wrong, it just takes some getting used to. I guess with the pistol grips, I'm thinking the pistol grips are probably more precise. You get what I'm saying? Because you loosen one hand, grab one hand or the other. This one, the T-bar, it kind of flows with you. It's the same way as, you know, and it's Toro, the same way as the Toro Time Master. The Toro Time Master has that personal pace system where once you get used to it, it almost feels like you're not even pushing it because it's like, you know, natural with your body. And I feel like that's how this T-bar is going to be. But right now, it's like all loose. Oh, now I got a phone call. All right, my bad. Yeah, like I said, it's like I'm all over the place with it. Like, and I think a little bit of it is because, like the guy said, that sometimes when you first get it, the belt is loose. So once I tighten those poles up, it got a little better. So I'm probably gonna end up tightening the poles up a little more. But I'm gonna cut with it Saturday to see how it is. And I can't wait to cut with it, man. It's like I was watching one of Top Notch's videos the other day, and he's like, once you get a new mower, then you can't wait to cut. Like, you know, he got that new, I think it's 52-inch Walker. And you just can't wait to cut, you know what I mean? But because that's what you work for, you know what I mean? Yes, you work for the money, you work to build your business, but when you get a new toy, You know, that's what makes it fun. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't know how to explain it, you know. Anyways, first impressions, like I said, when I cut, I stripe. So what I do is I make a square, a frame, I call it, around the yard or area where I'm gonna cut. So then that way, if there's like a fence or a neighbor's yard or something, I have an area to turn around in, you know, and go back on my next stripe. But see, the thing with this is, by being a walk behind, if y'all know how walk behinds are set up, it's so long. You know what I mean? It's so long, and then I have such a small deck, 36 inch, that it's hard for me to turn around with just one stripe. So I'm thinking I'm gonna have to make two stripes. I'm gonna have to go around the yard, make two stripes. You know, it might be a little time consuming, but, you know. Alright, yeah, the frame and, yeah, so I'm thinking I'm gonna have to go around twice and frame it. It might be a little time consuming, but that's where I got this more for. And so, you know, I'm thinking with, you know, I wanna cut it. I'm gonna cut with it this weekend. But I'm gonna try to cut with it as much as possible, but I'm gonna see how it does with the striping and see if I'm gonna add another rebar to it. Hills, man, I always thought that people said, oh, you know, if you want to cut a hill, you know, you should get a walk behind. Those people are crazy, because like when you're on a zero turn, right, and you're on a hill, like a, you know, an angle hill, you can feel when it starts to give. Like you can say, all right, all crap, you know, I'm about to start sliding. So you stop, you know, you pull back, stop, reevaluate, and then you keep going. Walk behind, you're not on it, you know what I mean? So you're controlling it. So you can't really tell that it's gonna give until you see it with your eyes start to give. And by that point, it's too late. It's going down the hill. So for me, cutting my ditch, I've learned that you gotta go slow. The faster you go, the faster you're gonna fall down the hill. But if I put it, like, it got five speeds, if I put it on one, you know, I'm gonna go cruising along, and you still feel the slide, but because you're going so slow, you're able to catch it and react to it because you're going so slow. Whereas, and if I was on three, I'm going so fast that it's just like, you know, I'm sliding down. So that's what I learned about that. Just go slow on them hills. But as far as the cut, cut's clean, man. It's very clean. Like when I cut my backyard here, I just showed y'all with them stripes. Because I don't really cut my yard that often this year because I've been so busy. It was pretty tall, pretty thick, and cut it, most it up with ease. And that's exactly why I got it, you know what I mean? Because not that the Time Master won't do in his job, but the Time Master can only do up to a certain point, you know what I mean? It's not meant to cut, you know, tall, thick grass or mulch tall, thick grass. It's meant to mulch decent grass because it only has a certain strength of motor. You know, this has a 14 horse motor. And it's so crazy, you know what I mean? Like, I feel so blessed. You know, the crazy thing about the 14 and a half motor that's on this, my very first riding mower was a 94 Murray with a 14 and a half horsepower motor. And now I have like a freaking push mower with the same motor. You know what I mean? So that's crazy. Man. Real excited. But pretty much not much going on. Like I said, we're going on a trip. So you're probably gonna see this video sometime while I'm on the trip. Then tomorrow when I go cut, I'm gonna try to vlog. I'm be by myself, even though I got like 10 yards. Like, so crazy. Like, I was trying to like finish up some yards before I go out of town, and I was with, I had like 4 or 5 yards. Then this week's been crazy. People just calling me, people been referring me, and now I'm up to like 10 yards that I got cut tomorrow and by myself. But this is the off week. This is the week that BJ that helped me. And coincidentally, the week that BJ does help me is the week I'm gonna be out of town. So he's gonna come and he's gonna cut some yards for me. So yeah, y'all should see this video sometime during the week of 4th of July. And then during that same week, I'm gonna post a vlog, and I'm gonna be using my mower, so look out for that. Then the week after that, then we'll post another tipsy talk. Then after that, I think I'll be vlogging again, and we'll be back on track. I've been posting like one video a week because I've been super busy, but I gotta put something together for you guys. I don't know if you guys like that that another one be another one. That was pretty fun. But thanks for watching. Comment, subscribe, and stay tuned. Yes, sir.